Should the Detroit Pistons still pursue DeAndre Ayton in free agency?
Stay tuned to find out!
It's easy. Speak easy, baby.
I got a million ways to get it. Choose one.
Choose one.
Hey. Bring it back. Bring it back. Now double your money and make it stack.
Please, 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 before we get started, make sure you guys hit that like and subscribe button. Do me a favor. If you enjoy the content, be a friend. Tell a friend. Let's hop into the video. As you guys know, the Detroit Pistons have acquired Jalen Duren in the 2022 NBA draft. However, beforehand, they were rumored to sign big name free agent DeAndre Ayton. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, initially I was like, yo, like that'd be dope, DeAndre Ayton and then Duren off the bench. But for being real about it, I don't think that Troy Weaver acquired Jalen Duren to have him sit on the bench. You guys gotta think about it this way. If we sign DeAndre Ayton to a 4-year max, that automatically designates Jalen Duren to the bench for his time with the Pistons. Now there's a lot of Detroit Pistons fans saying, hey, what about Tim Duncan and Tony Robinson? I'm just kidding. What about Tim Duncan and David Robinson? That's a whole different era of NBA basketball. That's just not the way today's league works. Today's league is predicated around wing play, three-point shooting, and defense. Today's league, the power forwards just have to be much more skilled. I mean, even if you have an elite big man, look how dominant guys like Joel Embiid are. Shoot, man, look at the back-to-back MVP, Nikola Jokic. Dude's balling, he's doing phenomenal when it comes to numbers, but is it winning basketball in terms of like winning championships? I don't think it's worth investing that amount of money in on top of having Jalen Duren and the high upside of what he's gonna be. I think DeAndre Ayton is a perfect example of that in himself. When DeAndre Ayton was the number two option with the Phoenix Suns, they were a lottery team. Kick him back, make him the third option with a facilitating point guard, and here they are making playoff runs and going to the finals. The thing too I wanna say is I think Jalen Duren offers like what you need, the qualities that you truly need in the big man in a winning recipe. And we kinda saw it, I know they didn't win the finals obviously, but I think you saw a little bit in Robert Williams and what he was able to provide for the Celtics in their finals run this year. You have an elite athlete who's willing to grab the boards and play defense. He doesn't always need the ball, but he's happy enough to clean up for you. And that's the type of effort you need. We have the perfect example of that here in Detroit with Ben Wallace. It's the unfortunate truth of the game nowadays. So no, I don't think it's a good idea for the Detroit Pistons to pursue DeAndre Ayton following the acquisition of Jalen Duren. I think it would be dope in the ideal situation where, you know, Duren does come off the bench and he's okay with that. And like it wasn't a burn of like a pick, I guess you'd call it. But ultimately, no.
It's definitely a no for me, dog.
Like, truthfully, try to think of a two big man lineup right now in the NBA to win a championship. But nonetheless, I appreciate you guys rocking with me for another video. Again, make sure you hit that like, subscribe button. Be a friend. Tell a friend. Make sure you guys check out my Jaden Ivey reaction video right here.
Somebody bring me back the money, please. Hey, hold on that new shit. Niggas like, how come?